morning, Haverford, and welcome to H Vision. I'm Allie Hamilton.
And I'm Gavin McMahon. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now let's go to Leah Besant with the weather.
Hello, Haverford High School. The weather outside today is 48 degrees. It's pretty nice outside, but a little bit chilly, with temperatures rising to 52 degrees in the afternoon. It also has a high of 52. Thank you. That was our weather today.
It's a clear and sunny day today.
Yeah, let's hope we get more of this nice, consistent weather towards the end of the school year.
Now let's go on to the morning announcements. Today is Wednesday, April 27th, and a B-Day.
Today is Denim Day. Thank you for showing your support.
Department chair meeting in room 235 at 2:30 p.m. after school today.
AACE is meeting after school today in room 208.
The Writing Center is open on Wednesdays after school in the library until 3:30. All grade levels are welcome. If you have any assignments in which you need some input or feedback, stop by after school.
Mamma Mia, Here We Go Again is back. Get your tickets now for April 27th, April 28th, and April 29th shows. Tickets are selling out fast. Come and see the amazing show.
Congratulations, boy volleyball, for defeating Avon Grove 3-0 yesterday.
For sports today, girls softball will host Springfield at the Haverford Reserve at 3:45 p.m., and boys tennis will host Avon Grove at the Haverford Tennis Courts at 3:45 p.m.
Best Buddies will be hosting the Rain Rally fundraiser to support our unified bocce and track and field teams. This fundraiser provides the funding needed for both teams. To be eligible for a t-shirt, participants must sign up by May 6 and raise a minimum of $35. Be sure to sign up now.
Fashion Club clothing drive will be extended to the first week in May. Please drop off any gently used clothing in the box in the main office. Thank you for your support.
Discovery Day is back. Saturday, May 14th. Come out to the high school from 10 to 1 for a good time.
Now let's go on to our features. Up first, we have a review on the album YEAT LP titled Up to Me.
Good morning, Haverford. I'm Strummer Kellett.
And I'm Gavin McMahon.
Haverford's busiest music nerds.
And today we'll be reviewing Portland rapper YEAT's 23-track LP, Up To Me. It was released in September 2021, and it cemented itself as one of the best albums from that year.
From the first time I heard it, it was a complete earworm, with its unique beats, heavy synthesizers, and most importantly, unique style of using bells on all the tracks. YEAT really shows his full vocal range and potential with this LP. He is cementing his spot in hip-hop, showing he's not going anywhere.
YEAT's melodramatic intro, Come On, really shows off his Young Thug and Future influence.
The next notable track is YEAT's breakout single, Get Busy. The song started from a humble snippet and made its way all the way to mainstream music. With cosigns from both Drake and The Weeknd. It shows YEAT's place in music, and he is not going anywhere. The song is really quite simple, but it really blew up from the iconic line. The song as a whole lyrically isn't very impressive, but it's always going to be an important part of his career.
Swerved It is the next song we're going to talk about. Swerved It is one of the most boastful songs on the album. It talks about his cars, his money, and how when he throws a show, the whole venue is jumping.
On the song Ya Ya, YEAT discusses the struggles of fame and how he is living too fast of a life. With the YEAT really takes into perspective how he isn't stopping and smelling the roses and just living life at too fast of a pace. He sees how easily it is that rappers go through their career and get burnt out very quickly, and he doesn't want that to happen to him.
The track, You Could Tell, has received critical acclaim after being featured on the hit show Euphoria. The deeper meaning of this song is that when you start to gain fame and money, people will start to show their true colors and their true character.
The song Back On 'Em acts as almost an interlude for this album, landing basically directly in the middle of it. It's a dramatic record, acting as a spot to speak his mind and how he really feels. He talks about people not understanding his vocals, telling them to just listen and figure it out, and how people have made a mockery of him for it.
Money So Big is a synth-filled rage track produced by Tragic and Nest. This track is filled with rhymes and metaphors to describe his financial gain in the music industry. Money So Big is Yeat's biggest song off the album, and it's my personal favorite from the track as well. A lot of the success from this track came from it blowing up on TikTok since it was trending and viral for a while. Although it can be classified as a TikTok song, that shouldn't take away from the fact that this is one of the best songs he's ever released.
Yeat rounds out this album with one of his best songs to date, Lying for Fun. The first half of this song acts as a discussion of how he has achieved the life that he's always wanted to live through the power of manifestation. On a heavy synthesized and drum-filled track, this really lets Yeat's full vocal range show. The song begins to fade out, but then the beat starts to play in reverse. It's very confusing at first, until the beat gets almost quiet and you hear Yeat say, "You must have thought I would die." He leads this into a very boastful second half, filled with heavy drums and bells, talking about his life now as a star. He talks a lot about being original, saying lines such as, "Why can't you just be yourself? If you're not a lame, don't you have nothing to hide?" With his newfound success, it's hard to not have people emulate his sound. But with this track, he makes it clear that there's only one person that can do it like him. He also talks about really living how he raps, saying, "I don't even know how to lie, can't bluff." This song ends, leaving the album off at a very high note. Overall, I would give this album a light 8.
And I would give it a heavy 8. I think we should just round it out and give it an 8 overall.
Sounds good to me.
Transition.
What do you think of this album? How would you rate it? Do you like Noah Oliver Smith? Let us know. Thank you, Fords.
Overall, that album was pretty good.
Twizzy Rich.
Up next, we have a feature highlighting our African-American studies class here at Haverford.
Yes, my name is Leon Smith, Mr. Smith, and I teach a class called African-American Studies. So I started this class. I've been teaching at Haverford for over 20 years, and there was not a lot of discussion about the contributions and the experiences of African Americans in our history books. Oftentimes, when African Americans were discussed in history books, it was always about slavery. It was always about suffering. And it didn't talk about the many contributions, the many civilizations and accomplishments that African American people have brought to not only the country but to the world. And so as I've gone throughout my teaching career, you know, there would be frustration that I would experience when I would look in textbooks and it would say, you know, African Americans in World War II, and it would be a paragraph. And I would know that there would be great, contributions that African Americans made when you think about groups like the Tuskegee Airmen and other stories that I had learned from experiences with my parents and in church. And so as I've read more, I would oftentimes include these topics in my teaching. There's so much to be discussed here, and I'm trying to do it in this course that I normally teach. Let's do another course where I can really get into it and spend more time. So one of the areas that I really wanted to start out with is ancient African civilizations. As I stated earlier, so too frequently, students' first experience with people of color is experience of slavery, and that is so off. When we look at ancient African civilizations like Kemet, which was ancient Egypt, these are great civilizations where there was learning. You know, people, when you think about Timbuktu, people came from all over the world to learn in Africa. We learn about the African presence in the Americas. A lot of people think about Columbus, but there was African presence in the Americas early on. We also talk about slavery and the impact that that had not only on people of color, but also on the world. How this money that is made for this has really allowed society to be as economically prominent as it is. We also look at current issues, things like mass incarceration. We watch a really powerful documentary by Ava DuVernay called 13th We talk about accomplishments. We talk about things like African-American astronauts and scientists, the Negro Leagues we talk about. And so we really have some great conversations around those types of topics. I'm so passionate, honestly, because it is something that I feel is left out of history books. I want to be the best history teacher that I can. And so often we're having the experiences of historically marginalized groups that in our textbooks are not represented. And if we want to be the best that we can be, we have to tell the whole story. Many students of color, like myself, African-American students, when they would sit in history classes, they did not feel like the story included them. It didn't represent them. And so one of the things I'm passionate about is I want more students of color to become teachers. And so if you are in a history class and you are not learning about things that apply to you, the idea of mirrors and windows, if you're looking at your textbook, you don't see people that look like you, then you're not gonna like the class and you're not gonna think that, you know, people that look like you ever accomplish anything. And that goes for anybody. And so that's wrong. So we have to tell these stories that so that people, as we get older, as we operate in society, can see that so many different groups have contributed to this wonderful society that we live in. I say, come on and sign up, because this is going to be a class that is going to have you talking after you leave the class. That you're going to, your eyes are going to be open, you're going to be learning about things, and every day you leave, you're going to be sitting there like, wow, I did not know that. You know, you're going to be telling your friends, you're going to be talking to your family members about it. And so it's a class where we build a classroom community. It's a class where we have opportunities for discussion. And it's a class that really is going to open your eyes and allow you to see the world in ways that you didn't see it before. And it's allow you to learn new things that you don't normally learn in a core class. So please come out and take it. It's a great class, and you'll really have a great experience.
I decided to take the class because I didn't really know much about African-American history. I only knew like the stuff that we were originally taught, like Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, and all them people. So yeah, that's why I took the class.
I took the class because there are not like a lot of things like that we learn about Black history, and like some stuff are like kind of sugarcoated into it. It's not really like a lot of textbooks, so that's why I wanted to like take the class.
My favorite part about this class is it's a nice class. It's a lot of people. It's a lot of diversity in the class, and you walk in with an open mind. Like, you don't know a lot of stuff, but then you walk out, you know a lot of stuff that you've never even heard of before. So that's why.
It's so good to have a class that really dives into African American history.
Yeah, it looks like a very culturally informative class.
That's all the time we have for today. I'm Allie Hamilton.
And I'm Gavin McMahon. Stay classy, Haverford.
Nicely done. I like